Live from Montauk, New York, it's the Friday Night Hustle, starring Nancy Atlas. Nancy's guests tonight include, well, special guests. So sit back and enjoy yourself in your quarantine fantasy land. I'm Johnny Blood, and enough of my rambling. Here's Nancy Atlas.
Hi, everybody. Please stand for the national anthem. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Crying. Hi, everyone. Oh, I've been so emotional today. How is everyone doing? Who do we got? Woo! I started that one a little too high. A little too high. A little too high for Mama. Oh. All right. Woo! You know what? I just gotta crank Neil for a second. Twitch hat. My husband steals it from me all the time, but it's my hat and I own the damn hat. And so it's me, mine, no one can share it. I know the video's all jerky, Karen, because I have three kids. And in a perfect world, I'd have a studio, but I am like one step short of that movie about the pirates with broadcast radio. And they're all watching movies right now and crushing me is what they're doing. They're crushing me. So it should get better because it just yelled at them. This is Hot Mess Productions. That's the name of my production company. Yeah, it's all right. We'll get through it. So how has everybody's week been? All right? Hold on a second. Woo! That's right. My hat is my hat. There's no messing with my hat. Hot Mess Productions right here. I got my watermelon. You know what? I am now an official sponsor of Montauk Brewery. Not really, but I'm going. They gave me a mask too. Look. It's a Montauk Brewery mask. Pretty cool, right? Let me see what I got here. Let me see if I can help out with this. No, there's nothing. It says 720. All right. All right, so we got a lot going on, man. We got Debbie Gebert in the house today. You know how busy I was if I couldn't even stop at Boswick's to pick up some food by Debbie, who is just absolutely one of the best caterers out here. Boswick's is now doing food to go, which is amazing. If you live on the Hamptons area, or even if you don't, you want to just take a day trip, come on, baby. Why not? She has amazing, amazing things going to you. So, all right. Yes, I had a doubleheader, Annie. Oh, please rise for the national anthem. You can sit down now. I feel like I'm in church. Hold on a second. Holy smoking Joe, guys. I had my first virtual event today. I had my first virtual event from 5:30 to 6:30. So, yeah, I have to say I had a glass of wine and I stopped there because it wasn't going to work. I'm going to kill these damn kids if they'd... Oh, up to 8 likes already just for having a glass of wine. I have to be honest with you. I always said whenever you come here, it's going to be upbeat and it's going to be, you know, an escape. But creating this show today... thank you. The 12. I see the little flurries of likes. They pop up on the thing. Creating the show today, it was definitely emotional for me. And I'm sure as it is for all of you, this weekend is the start of the summer season. If you live out on the East End, I know there's people that tune in all the way from California and DC, but on the East End, we are a tourist town and this is a big weekend, and it's just different. And so, you know, I would typically have a weekend of gigs all lined up, and I would be looking at starting my year, quite honestly. And instead, I am reflecting on videos for the most part, and that's why. And the emotion isn't so much a sadness. I've said this before, and I will say it again. So proud of the way that we lived in a time when we could live freer. Things are very free now, but we're just kind of shackled down in home. But when I look at the bonfires that we've had and the parties and how we really, really celebrated life together, and without a doubt, the countless Friday and Saturday nights that I've done at the Stephen Talk House with my band, this is the first time in 24 years that we were not playing the Talk House. And so I just would not accept that. And we went to the Talk House and we filmed a little something for everyone. So let's start out with that, shall we? Let's start out with that, saying hello to the guys. All right. And thank you for tuning in, everybody. So nice to see you. So great to see everybody. Hi, John. I'm going to say hello. Oh, Ashley, you cried on and off today. It's a very weird day today. Yes, it really is. And then when you think about also all of our the people in the hospitals helping and people that would, you know, love to be sitting in their basement with a flag behind them. But here we go. This will cheer you up, hopefully. It'll hopefully cheer you up, okay? My new nickname is One Take Nancy. Because they say, how do you get all this stuff done? Well, I do it in one take. Clam lady, everything, even though she's my friend and I film her, it's one take. All right, here we go. Hey guys, how you doing? It's the Nancy Atlas Project here. We're at the Stephen Talk House. Everyone's masked and at a total distance. We've come together to just play this one song for you for Memorial Day weekend. And to tell you that the Talk House, even though it's closed right now, we'll be doing some live streaming and some shows as we move forward in a socially distanced, safe, secure way. So check in to the Talk House website and look online as we do shows. And this is a little treat from everyone at the Talk House to you.
was kind of cold that night. She stood alone on a balcony. She could hear the cars roll by out on 441, like the waves crashing on the beach. And for one precious moment, oh, he slipped back in a memory. God, it's so painful, something that's so close and still so far out of reach. Oh yeah, alright, take it easy baby, make it last all night. She was an American girl. Johnny Blood!
Wait. Let's see what it says.
Hey guys, how you doing? It's the Nancy Atlas Project here.
All right. See, we couldn't have missed that. We couldn't have missed We Are Thankful for the Times We Shared. That just wouldn't be better. Hey, so the exciting news is that I turned my phone off and back on. I am happy to report that I have officially got a good camera coming this week for this live stream. You will be all very proud of me. Hold on, we'll get there. I have been doing this on a wing and a prayer, people. On a wing and a prayer! But As Annie said, we did our first virtual event. I know how. All right, so let me read how everybody's doing. Let me check in. Yeah, I know. So up, there's the first burp. Sorry. All right, we have some hot mess going on here too. No, that's happy birthday, Susan. We don't need Oh my God. This is just too funny. I'm sorry. This is really funny. This is it's the event I just played. Happy birthday, Susan. Still watching. Richard, can you borrow this top? Can I just say that this top is usually loose and I am stacking. I actually, there are genuinely pants I do not fit in anymore. Couldn't care less. And you know what? I'm going to drink to that. I'm going to drink my Montauk Watermelon Session Ale to that. Hi, Colleen. Let me put a little background music on. It's like running a little Talking Heads. I'm digging the music tonight. Hey, Colleen, how you feeling? Hey, Rachel. Bob K, how you doing, Bob K? Oh, Rich Rita. Rita, where are you at? You out here? I love this song too. All right, so listen, we got lots to do here. So here's the deal. The theme of this show hinges around American Pie. And for anyone that is just tuning in, you should know off the bat, hello, my name is Nancy Atlas. I'm a singer-songwriter from the East End of Long Island that can no longer play music, so I am in my basement live streaming and keeping us all together. It comes from a movie, American Pie, which some very naughty followers suggested, but we all must watch it together because we must understand the theme of tonight's show. So, if somebody gets offended, I have to say to you that it is not my fault. It is the people that chose this theme's fault, like Ashley and Richard. It's their fault. But so let's watch a little American Pie movie so that we are all in on this theme together. This is a 1999 classic from Universal that the FCC will also arrest me for.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but you're the one with the girlfriend and you're still stranded on third base.
Hey, at least I know what third base feels like, okay? You're still just a bat boy.
Bat? What are you talking about? Guys, what exactly does third base feel like?
You want to take this one?
Like warm apple pie.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Apple pie, huh?
Uh-huh.
McDonald's or homemade?
Gentlemen, destiny awaits.
Mom! Home!
Do it. Do it. Oh! Always in. It's bringing me back to high school. I'm sorry. This is so wrong and so right. Uh-oh. Oh no. Here comes the dad.
Oh, yeah.
Pop! Jim?
It's not what it looks like.
Well,
just tell your mother that we ate it all.
Ian, first of all, I have to admit something. I don't know really what it is. It's a slight crush on Eugene Levy. I adore him, the father, so much. And I think it's just from all the movies. Like, I am a massive, massive, massive fan of his. Oh, sorry. Let's put a little talking head. Okay, so that's our theme for tonight. That's our theme. And I say she's gonna have a quick touch on it, but I think we go right into the apple pie from there with Debbie Gebert. Debbie is an amazing caterer out here, okay? If you ever have any kind of private event that you want at your house and stuff dropped off, she also does Bostwick's, but it's like the real deal stuff. It's the kind of food. It's also, you know, like Art of Eating with Cheryl as well. There's certain caterers out here that just crush it. And she is definitely one of them. So Bostwick's, so excited about that. Can't wait to go there. All right, Debbie, you're up to bat, baby. Here's our apple pie.
Warm apple pie. The fascination.
Huh? We'll just tell your mother that we ate it all.
Hey everyone. No shit, I just did this whole video segment piece before this, and it came out to be 11 minutes, and I didn't even have the crust on the pie. You know, I am the Inda Eaton of cooking tutorials. I can't help myself. I go on with stories, and it's just what I do. I can't help it. So we're gonna do a Reader's Digest version really quickly, because look, I have the pie ready to go in the oven here, but we're just gonna crazy. The one thing I do want to say is that the term easy as pie, I was curious about that term because pie is not necessarily easy. And if it was, people would do a lot more of it, making of it. So I got curious and I found out that the term actually comes from Australia. Easy as pie was actually based on the Maori word pai, P-A-I, which means you're really good at something. So if you were really good at something, it was easy as pie. So I'm not sure how it got to America and easy as pie, P-I-E, as in this pie. I think that a pie term that's probably more appropriate is pie in the sky, which is the meaning of that term is something that is pleasant to contemplate, but unlikely to be realized. And that's how I think most people think about pie. You know, they're afraid of it, and then they break down and they go to Caresses or they go to Tate's. God forbid, you know, don't go to the frozen food aisle and buy Mrs. Smith's. Please don't do that. Makes me really sad. But anyway, you can do this. It's actually very simple. And we're going to do the easiest version of it. What my mother did growing up, and look, it was a great pie. Look, it from the Betty Crocker cookbook. So really simple. You're going to get a couple of different apples. You're going to get like a green apple, Macintosh, Macoon. You want to stay away from apples like Gala or Red Delicious or Yellow Delicious. But get a couple of apples. And you're gonna slice them really thin. Thin, all right? And it doesn't have to be hard. Take your apple, you cut it, right? And you take out the middle like this. Take out the middle, you peel it like that, and you slice. You slice thin slices. That's what you do in a bowl. You're gonna get like 6 to 8 cups, depending on your pie shell. This is a little tin pie shell. Well, you need like 4 or 5 cups. Your big glass Pyrex, you might need 8 cups. Okay, in with the apples. Okay, back up. As you're peeling the apples, get a bowl of water, squeeze a couple of lemons in them. So as you're slicing the apples, they're in that lemon water so they don't turn brown. Get all your ingredients ready. You're gonna need some flour, some sugar, some cinnamon, some nutmeg. get it all ready to go. Drain your apples, put them in the bowl, couple of tablespoons of flour, good sprinkling of cinnamon, maybe a teaspoon, couple of shakes of nutmeg, or I have those little nutmegs that you grind in. Always put in about a half a teaspoon of salt. Salt brings up the flavor of things. Flour, sugar, a couple of tablespoons of flour. It's going to thicken the juices as it cooks. Cinnamon, nutmeg, salt. Good. Done. Mix it all up. There you go. There you go. You're going to have your pie crust already in your shell. Whether you make it homemade, that's a whole nother thing. You know, a homemade pie, you know, go to Food Network. Ina Garten's perfect pie crust is pretty perfect, I have to say. I just added a little cinnamon to the pie crust. If making a pie crust is way more than you can deal with, then by all means, I give you permission to go buy a Pillsbury. But if you're gonna do it, like, try it. Pie crust, it takes practice. That's it. But definitely use real apples. Use real apples. Don't, oh God, I hate the stickers on apples. No wire hangers, no stickers on fruit. Use real apples. Don't buy the canned stuff in the store. Don't buy the jar of cooked apples from the roadside place in Massachusetts that tail sells terrible food. Don't do it. Real apples. Just do it. Okay? How do we make it a boozy apple pie? I took some dried cranberries and I let them soak in some rum. They usually say dark rum. I don't have dark rum. Again, no rules. What do I have? I have some honey rum. Honey rum in apple pie. God, how can you not go wrong? Honestly, again, no rules. I put the apples in the pie. I sprinkle the honey rum soaked cranberries. And instead of putting another pie crust over, because it's Memorial Day, look what I did. I cut out little pastry stars. I laid them on the pie. Look at that. There we go. Oh, I'm making a mess. I just spilled. Get an egg and some cream. Brush your pastry. You're going to brush your pastry, and then you're going to get a little granulated sugar, and you're going to sprinkle. Okay, this is going to go into a 375 oven. I'll see you in a minute.
Oh, Stewie and Brian, you're just in time for pie.
Did somebody say pie? It's a wonderful day for pie. You can ask all the birds in the sky, and they'll tell you real sweet with a musical tweet.
It's a wonderful day for pie.
For pie.
For pie.
For pie.
For pie.
This is wonderful, Brian. Oh, let's live in this universe.
Hey, everybody. Pie's out of the oven. I just wanted to say, I got thrown in the beginning because I had done that 12-minute video that wasn't even two-thirds done, and I never said who I am. I am Debbie Geppert, and I want to thank Nancy for, asking me to do this. It was a lot of fun. And Nancy, this beautiful, it's still very hot, apple pie, boozy apple pie, is coming to you, my dear. I'm gonna send it your way, and I hope that you all come and see me at Bostwick's Clam Bake and Catering Company Market, because we do make pies there, different kind of pies, clam pies, lobster pies. Actually, we're gonna have blueberry pie there this weekend. But anyway, I'm having some of my honey rum. To everyone, have a happy and safe Memorial Day weekend. It's the official unofficial start of summer. All right, cheers.
Dude, I get the pie? Did she just tell me that I get the pie? Take that. Hold on. I get the pie. I get the pie. My boobs are so happy about the pie. Cheers, Debbie. Cheers. You'll see me tomorrow, bitch. I couldn't get there today, but I'll get there. Oh my God, I get the pie. I get the pie. Oh my God, third burp. Third burp. I bet this Montauk Brewery, so that's why. Can I crank this a little louder? Is that all right? Okay. So listen to me. I have an idea, but I can't make that idea fruition because I have a lot of ideas. One of the crazy things about this, whatever the hell it is, the rapture, as my friend Inda likes to call it, I'd like to do a version of American Pie with all, see, now I get choked up. Now I get choked up. Hold on a second. I need a sip of my beer. I would like to do a version of American Pie with all of the artists on the East End. I mean, really, all of the artists. It's so long, and have everybody take a line and produce it and have everybody sing it and video it and be something to look forward to in the fall. It would be a really big thing to take on. But until then, this kind of came to my mind this week as I was doing that. And so I remember seeing this version of it. And if you've ever seen it, I'm sure you have, a lot of you have. It's worth seeing again. It's 9 minutes, but it is the world record for lip dubbing. And it is I believe it's Grand Rapids. The entire town got together and lip synced this. So I thought we would all watch it together for Memorial Day. With the thought of how beautiful it will be someday soon when we can do this with all of our artists here on the East End. Okay. Hang bat. Let's talk to each other and connect. And if you've never seen this, you're in for a treat. It's long, but if you can believe it, they did this all in one take.
Miss American Pie, drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys are drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die. Can you help me out a little on that? Bye, bye, Miss American Pie, drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys are drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day.
You can sing all the words if you know them. Long, long time ago, I can still remember how that music used to make me smile. And I knew if I had my chance that I could make those people dance. Maybe they'd be happy for a while. But February made me shiver with every paper I deliver. Bad news on the doorstep, I couldn't take one more step. I can't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride, but something touched me deep inside the day the music died. So bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die.
Did you write the book of love, and do you have faith in God above? Bible tells you so. Now do you believe
in love with him, 'cause I saw you dancing in the gym. You both kicked off your shoes. Man, I dig those red lemon blues. I was a lonely teenage punk and buck with a pink carnation and a pickup truck. Stole his thorny crown. The courtroom was adjourned. No verdict was returned. Yet while Lennon read a book on Marx, a quartet practiced in the park, and we sang dirges in the dark. The day the music died, we were singing bye bye Miss American Pie. Machete to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die. Helter skelter in the summer swelter, the birds flew off with a fallout shelter. 8 miles high and falling fast, it landed foul on the grass. The players tried for a forward pass with a jester on the sidelines in a cast. Now the halftime air was sweet perfume while the sergeants played a marching tune. We all got up to dance, oh, but we never got the chance. As the players tried to take the field, the marching band refused to yield. What was revealed the day the music died? We started singing, bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Oh, we shed it to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. A generation lost in space, with no time left to start again. So come on, Jack, be nimble, Jack, be quick. Jack Flash sat on a candlestick, 'cause fire is the devil's only friend. Why, and as I watched him on the stage, my hands were clenched in fists of rage. No angel born in hell could break that Satan spell. And as the flames climbed high into the night to light the sacrificial rite, I saw Satan laughing with delight. The day the music died, he was singing bye bye Miss American Pie. Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die.
I met a girl who sang the blues, and I asked her for some happy news. She just smiled and turned away. And I went down to the sacred store where I'd heard the music years before, but the man there said the music wouldn't play. And in the streets the children screamed, the lovers cried and the poets dreamed,
Not a word was spoken. The church bells all were broken. And the three men I admire most, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, why, they caught the last bus for the coast the day the music died. And they were singing, bye-bye, this American pie. Rode my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. And them good old boys were drinking whiskey and pie, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die.
See the helicopter coming, man. I didn't watch it all the way through. Oh my god. Yeah, do you know that that one video basically increased a massive amount of tourism in that town? I mean, I think they that's my third burp. And Roger Ebert said it was the best music video ever made. I just think it's just so... Oh, let's do a little Frank. Hold on. I just think it's so awesome. We're singing, why not? Happy Memorial Day, everybody. Happy Memorial Day.
Spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York. These vagabond shoes.
Whoops.
Are longing to stray.
I think before I go to where I want to go with that, we're going to go to New York. Frank, you know what? I'm going to come back to you. I'm going to just do a little bit more of... You knew that there was just... there was absolutely no way that my band was getting together and not playing twice, so... All right. How about a little White Rabbit, guys?
Give me a little love on the top. She was just small.
Keep your fucking head, dude.
Words of wisdom. From a woman who's in love with a nipple man. Words of wisdom from a woman that's in love with a... Oh, you know what I feel like? I feel like this behind Nipple Man. Oh, yes, I do. Oh, it's backwards. Hold on, wait a second. Hold on. Oh, it's locked. It's locked. That's why. I'm sorry for people that are turning it. Sorry. Okay, Rebecca's laughing. I can't stop. I can't stop. All right. Hey, Cynthia, what's up? Tips? CD! Okay, sorry. I forget sometimes that people are actually watching. Don't stop! I can't stand. Don't make me stand. I'm in my comfy, cozy chair. Oh, that was enjoyable for me. I hope it was enjoyable for you. Oh, that was so good. Nipple Man, I love you, bro. I love you. Hey, guys, we have a really special message from... I don't often like to bring exes into my show, but... he contacted me and he asked if he could have a message to you guys. So I was like, yeah, whatever. So here's a message from one of my ex-boyfriends.
Hey, it's Tom Petty. What's up? I'm up in heaven, so I know you guys are having a little bit of a rough patch, but it doesn't really affect me because I'm gorgeous 1970s Petty. Anyway, I'm having my ex-girlfriend, Nancy Atlas, send you a reminder that when the chips are down, do not forget about the P.O.P. people, the power of Petty. You gotta crank some of that old music right up. Stoke up that grill. I mean, what do you want? I was an angry Southern boy. Nothing better than that. With a chip on the shoulder, serve that with steak and a side of beer. I'll tell you, it's going to fix just about anything. So, happy Memorial Day. And don't ever forget that salvation is just one little click on your phone away. Crank up some classics, baby, and you'll feel better in a jiff. That's right. Tom Petty says the word jiff. I can do whatever I want now, because I'm in heaven.
God. We had our days, but I had to break up with him. I had to. Anyway, listen, steak and a side of beer. Do you even call it a side of beer? What would you even call that? Steak and a seltzer, and Tom Petty can cure just about anything, damn it. I have been, I don't know about you guys, but I have really made a point when I'm having a bad day to crank up my favorite music for sure. Hey, Johnny Blood, also an ex-boyfriend of mine. Johnny and I are born the same day. We're just buddies. He has a message for you as well. He recorded this literally, I think, about 24 hours ago. I'm not even kidding. He recorded this for you guys. So here we go. This is from Johnny Blood, guitarist. Can you imagine being able to do that in a day? Damn. So let me ask you something, guys. Karen called, and she has a pie recipe. I don't know. Do we want Karen to make a pie for us? I don't know if we want to do that. Johnny, that was beautiful. Thank you so much for that beautiful message. And your house looks gorgeous with the flag on it. Do we want Karen to give us a live feed for a... you remember, anybody remember Karen from COVID-19 dating? Do we want a live feed from Karen? I don't know. I'm not seeing anything. Only Jack is saying that he wants a Karen. Yeah? Or are we not feeling Karen? If we're not feeling Karen, Karen does not need to make an appearance. You know, she was the contestant number two who was chosen last week. Oh, we like Karen? Okay. But in the meantime, okay, so when we started this out, hold on. When we were starting on the show out, somebody asked, hey, how are you doing? And I said, it was emotional putting the show together today because I would think of things and, you know, it made me feel today. Hold on, I'm going to do a little sexy motherfucker by Prince because it's just the way I'm rolling today. So what the freak, dude? Sorry. So here's the deal. Karen's going to come and say hi in a minute. I miss fireworks. There's usually fireworks. So I just looked for some fireworks and I found, you know, I'm going to do Frank Sinatra while I'm talking about this. I found this old footage from 2 years ago from New York. And it was the 4th of July fireworks. But it touched me so deeply seeing this. Our beautiful city that has been like so ravaged in the last 2 months. You know, we're out in this utopian bliss out on the East End. But we're New Yorkers. All of us are New Yorkers. And so I thought we would watch some fireworks together, everyone. We're still going to get back to the music, but we would watch the power of New York together and Memorial Day fireworks for all of our firemen and police and hospital and essential workers. And let's just sit together and have a beer and watch at the power and magnificence of our incredible city. So it's about 5 minutes long. And if you're not feeling fireworks, it's fine. But Mama's feeling some fireworks, so we're going to watch some fireworks. What's up, everybody? It's Karen. I'm here with my brother, and this is my other brother over here. Yeah, what's going on? So yeah, so I heard it was like a pie. I heard it was a pie episode, and me and John Jameson. We're having a good time, and I really love that Debbie lady, but the problem is that, who the hell needs an apple pie right now? Nobody needs an apple pie. What I find all men want right now is a clam pie. So I decided that I called up Nancy, and I just said, Nancy, I have an incredible clam pie for you. And so I'm just going to put it together. I'm out on my brother's boat, so I can't really do it justice. I don't have a like an oven or anything. So I'm just going to show you ingredients, which kind of works for this fucking broadcast anyway, because none of the goddamn fucking chefs here ever tell you if it's a cup or, you know, or a teaspoon. They just like, oh, put an apple in, or, oh, here's corn nuts. I don't know, a bag. How much oil? A girl needs to know about oil if she's going to make corn nuts. Anyway, okay. So you have your Progresso Italian. You got your Progresso Italian here. You have your clams to make a clam pie. For some reason, I don't understand, but men seem to love the smaller clams. I don't know why. All right. What else you have in your kitchen? You have an onion. Get an onion. Chop up the onion. So here's what you do. You take the Progresso. You put it in here like that much, because that's exactly how they do it on this show. You take an onion, chop it up. You put it in there too. You chop up the clams. You put it in like that. You mix it all together. Maybe crack an egg. There's my make-believe egg. All right. You put the egg in there. And I don't know, a little oregano. Now, what you want to do is the difference between my pie and other people's pie is that, you know, this is a pie that you the guy's going to, like, you know, get down with. So, clam pie. So, I like to take this. I make it in. I just put the batter in this with a prearranged. I take one of my old, what's a who's-a-ma what's-a, you know, the thing that the paper towel's on. And let's just pretend, since I'm not in the kitchen, you take, this is the dough, all right? And so you stick the roll, the leftover roll, not toilet paper, because my guy, he's got a big, he's got a big schlong. So you gotta, if this isn't love, I don't know what is. All right, so you put it here, and then the batter goes around it, you know? The batter goes around, and then here's more batter. You want the batter to go deep, deep and thick, and then, shut up, James. All right, and then you put it in the oven, 350, hold on, make sure it's straight, unless, you know, he's got a hook. Then you can hook it, but, and then you bake it at 350, for, I don't know, 30 minutes until it's warm and crusty. And then you take this out, you take that out, and he's got a nice little hole that he can just, you know, pop right onto the warm clam pie. And it's fabulous. It works out great in quarantine sometimes, you know, when you don't feel like touching anybody. Here, honey, I made you a clam pie. It's really, really good. Anyway, I hope you're enjoying the show. Happy Memorial Day. James Jameson and I broke up already. I don't want to talk about it. He took all of my Marlboros. But anyway, happy Memorial Day, everybody. Here's a real chef from Louisiana. I think I didn't want to follow him, so I went first. Thanks, Nancy. Yeah, listen, I hope you're all doing well. All right. Hold on a second. I'm blind. Can't see a goddamn thing without my glasses. Where are you, sweet bee?
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again. Your heart is true, you're the pal.
Wow, wow. We had a little guest appearance by Betty White. What's more American, more Memorial Day than Betty White? She's been around for 90 years or better. You know, tonight's show, listen, we're going to celebrate and everything about America. You know, first we're gonna make a burger. We're going to add a different kind of stuff in there, which most people do. We're also going to make a potato salad with three different kinds of potatoes, which is a little different. But if you try it, you'll really love it. Then, of course, we're going to do the all-American hot dog in a different twist. And we're going to have some bacon-wrapped dogs, and we're going to have bacon-wrapped corn on the cob. Really a good show tonight. I'll get everything set up, and then we'll start filming. All right, here we have our ground meat. We crack one egg. Put it in. How about a little sweet pea seasoning? And then for breadcrumbs, we're using these chips here. I love to use this. It gives it a different flavor in your burger. And it's just a really awesome taste. And
You can do the breadcrumbs if you like, but I like to do different flavor chips. Today we're using these. I just crush them up, put them in. And but if you like onions, nacho cheese chips, anything like that, you can just go ahead and mix it in here. And once you get it good mixed up, then we'll make our burger patties. I'm gonna add a little more of the chips in. And then we'll create our burger patties and we'll put them on the stove, get them fried up. And then we're gonna top them off with a little cheese, a little guacamole, just everything that I like. I don't care about anybody else today. This is my burger. Okay, we'll be back in a second. Okay, what we're doing, we're gonna pan fry these burgers. And just, we put a little bit of butter in the bottom and we're just gonna take our time and let them cook. And while these are cooking, we're gonna get busy and we're gonna make the potato salad with the three different potatoes. So let's get ready to do it. Okay, here we go. What we did, we parboiled our potatoes, which we have Irish potatoes and russet potatoes there. Then here's the twist. Add you some sweet potatoes in it mix. And it could be right out of the can. We're using Bruce's, which is a Louisiana product, but it's available all over the place. You have that. I've got three boiled eggs. Come in here and take your boiled eggs and just get them all mashed up. Because you're gonna make you're gonna take some mayo and make your mix for your potato salad. Now this is the way we make it here. There's all kinds of ways to make potato salad. You know, basically on Sunday with my barbecue business, we make about 90 pounds of potato salad. Every week. Now, when I come in here in the mix, I'll add just a touch of mustard. Nothing big. It's just a little bit for really color. And then we add mayo. And we always kind of like to put a little mayo in our potato salad. And you mix this up. And this is going to be your creaminess for your potatoes. We add a little seasoning in here also. And I like to put a little bit in my potatoes. Now what's going to happen, you'll get a little sweet and sour really working here because with the, you get a little bit more mayo. What happens is with the sweet potatoes, it gives off this natural flavor. And with the other potatoes in there, and it's just a really, really good combination. So this is your mix. And what I like to do is, I don't like chunky potatoes out, so I just kind of get in there and just kind of mash them up a little bit. Not where it's a real like cream potato, but I just like little chunks. And then I mix up the sweet potatoes in there real good. Now, with that being said, then we come back in here and we add this mix and our potato salad and our potatoes, and we're gonna create potato salad. Okay, and all you do is just come in here and you mix this, and you know what? Potato salad's done. I mean, it's really an easy dish. And it's really, really awesome. So we got this completed on part of it. We got our burgers. We can fix it and flip our burgers over. And then we'll come back and I'll just show you how to do some bacon-wrapped corn and some bacon-wrapped dogs. And we'll put them in the oven and we'll be ready to start eating in a little bit. Thank you. Okay, here we go. You can use a little kernel of fresh corn. I mean, look, up in New York, you got some of the best corn. I remember that corn. And just season. To season it, and what's going to happen? It's not going to dry out on you. So you just come up here and you take your piece of bacon, and you can use a maple bacon, which is really awesome with this, or just any flavored bacon you like. You come in here and wrap this corn, put it on right here on the platter. and you'll cook it till the bacon's done, really, and the corn, of course, will be done. Then you take these all-American dogs, and give me one piece of bacon here. That was a great song back in his day. Still a great song. You take the dogs, just take them and wrap them. Cover the whole hot dog. And then you put these in the oven too. And just bake them off. There we go. And it doesn't take, you know, the dogs, you can start the corn and then add the dogs in later, because really the dogs will cook a little quicker than the corn. So you have this ready, then all you have to do is just slide this in the oven. And then when that is done, we'll bring up the finished product here in a little while. We'll have the burgers finished up and we'll start putting it together. See you in a bit. Okay, born in the USA. That's me and everybody else around me. I mean, we love America and everybody else loves America. Maybe some people don't, but we don't care. Anyway, listen, this Memorial Day is to honor all our fallen people who have fought for this country. Here we have our hot dogs. We have a little chili dog going on. We have American-made cheese on top of our burger. Here we got a little tomato with a little guacamole, bacon wrap on the corn, potato salad here. You know, this is a great meal. It's fun. I enjoy doing it. Enjoy Memorial Day. Man, thank you. Thank you, Betty White, for gracing us with your presence. I mean, she's unreal. I didn't think she'd come to Mira, Louisiana, but she did. Have a good one. Take care.
Now I want potato salad. Now I like, but I want it now. Bacon wrapped corn? If I was confident that my computer wouldn't crash, I would find that damn video of, and maybe we'll take that chance in a little bit. I'd find that video of me eating my, remember the corn I talked about last time? Let's see if anybody remembers the ingredients. You remember the corn I talked about 2 weeks ago? Let's see if anybody was listening. Who's going to be the first person? I'm up to 32 likes. How nice. Are we going to have a like rally? Anybody that's watching hasn't liked the little thing here? It doesn't matter. It's all seven of us, but it's honey Old Bay butter. Ashley Gardner for the win. Oh, was that Ann Rosh? Sorry. That's right. That's right. So it starts with the butter. Wait, let me think. What did it start with? It started with the butter, salted butter. Then you sprinkle Old Bay on it. Or you could do Old Bay first, I guess. But you sprinkle Old Bay on it with the butter. And then you roll that shit in local butter and honey. I may have to crash my computer to find that clip of me eating it in the summertime while one of these is going on. All right. So do you know what time it is? Do you know? Can you guess? I'm very excited about... Oh, by the way, sorry, you can't get it. Nothing says Memorial Day like Tom Cruise and Nipple Man together. Together at last, together forever. Oh, is there a really bad Wi-Fi delay? I'm sorry. Okay, I'm sorry. I yelled at my kids, and then I yelled at my husband, and I think he was streaming a movie or something. But anyway, we got to get him back on. He's got to sing a song for us. And then, I sent him an email. I'm lying. I didn't yell because I'm not anywhere in the house. Okay. It's a very promising astrology with our favorite. Are you ready? Here we go.
Hi, everybody. I had to start with that song because A, it's beautiful, and B, the stars are always shining bright above us, and we're always dreaming our world into being, right? Remember that. I'm Tracy Moore, and I'm your weekly astrologer. And I'm here to tell you that we have a really fantastic weekend ahead that's filled with energy and light. We have a new moon happening in Gemini, and we have our sun sign that just moved into Gemini. So when you have a new moon, the moon and the sun come together and hold hands. And it gives the influence of the sign it's in a lot of potency. So we have a lot of Gemini energy in the heavens. We have the planet Mercury, Venus, our sun, and our moon, four planets in Gemini. So we're going to be heavily influenced by this mercurial energy. Mercury is the planet that rules Gemini, and Gemini is all about the mind. It's all about intellect, witty witticisms. Gemini's multitask. They're fast-paced. They're inspiring. They're all things to do with words, right? Gemini is the planet of words, the zodiac sign of words, and writing, and books, and school. And it's one of those signs that may talk a lot. Also, they have a problem with an attention span issue, right? The Gemini sometimes are so busy in their minds that they're thinking about something else while they're doing something, you know? That's that. So you may find that that energy is abundant this weekend. This Gemini energy is also, particularly the moon, well aspected to a planet called Saturn this weekend. And that's a really good thing because Saturn is sort of a strict taskmaster, keeps everything very reserved, and has a lot of responsible energy behind it. So it's doing a really nice thing with this Gemini energy, which will keep us a lot calmer than we may feel we are. So we have a more patient quality about ourselves this weekend in the midst of all this zippy kind of, you know, fast-paced, new beginning kind of an energy field. So it's a really wonderful new moon, a great chance to for my authors and my writers in the house. Good time to put that paper and pen together and get it going on. So finish that book, write that song, right? Let your creative mind really go with the flow of that feeling. One thing I do want to give you a heads up about, we also have an aspect in the heavens that's a little difficult, may make our relationships a little confusing. It also, this is an aspect that may lend ourselves to this sort of personal insecurity. I mean, Lord knows, you know, like when was the last time you like really looked at your toenails in the past 3 months, or, you know, saw that you need a little hair coloring, right? So insecurities may be a little bit abundant with yourself and perhaps relationships you're in. But a great opportunity to communicate with people this week, and anything having to do with communication and emoting from communicating. Don't let your mind spin out. Still come from your heart. Happy new moon, people. Stay well. Stay safe.
How you doing, guys? I'm so much feeling so much better than where we started tonight. I hope you're feeling good too, man. Did I just hold on a second? There it goes. Lay down, Sally. This is a good one. Hold on. Find someone to go to. Oh, good night, Nancy. All right, listen. I have I was talking to my good friend Nick Krause. Nick Krause, like a brother to me. We've gone a long time. And Nick has worked on a lot of different things with I've done Wounded Warrior with Nick for years, Soldier Ride. I sang the national anthem for years. And now he started something that's called USA Warrior Stories. And I asked him literally today as I was flying around, hey, can you send me something? And he said, yeah, I have a vet from East Hampton. And so I think we just need to take a minute and to watch this together. It is Memorial Day weekend, as Jack had mentioned, and I've had such an honor working with our soldiers over the years, and such a spirit. So this is USA Warrior Spirits. If it's also the same name as the, I think it has the website on it, but if you hashtag it, just USA Warrior Stories, that's also on Instagram for a thing. But here we go. Let's watch this. I haven't watched this yet. He literally just sent it over to me at about 6 o'clock, so I thought it would be something.
My name is Lee Hayes. I was born in 1922, and in Virginia, and we came from Virginia to New York in 1930. My father had run out of work in Virginia, so a brother of his that lived here and got him a job in Amagansett on a dairy, and he came up and built a little house for us and went back to Virginia and brought the whole family. And I was the oldest, so that's why it was a little harder on me. I guess I had to come out of school before I graduated high school and go to work to help the family, to help support them. I wanted to go in early because I knew about the outfit that what they were doing. They were training blacks, of course, I read about them. But what kept me back was my mother, you know, and I always obeyed my mother. And even though I was, you know, up in age, I wouldn't go and take the exams unless she agreed to it. But they drafted me, and that's how I got into service. I wasn't particularly fond of service, but I just wanted to learn how to fly. But when I got in, I think I was in a couple of years before I got into the training program. And how I got there into the program is there was a friend that I met. And he was interested in getting into the training program, and we got talking together about the program. And so I told him what my problem was, that my mother didn't want me, didn't approve of it. So he said, why don't you keep asking and see what she says? So I kept asking, and she finally agreed to it. She said, if that's what you want, go ahead. It seemed rather easy to me. It always was easy. I don't know how I got through, because they said you're supposed to have had 2 years of college or equivalent thereof. My friend had his 2 years, but I didn't. But everything came rather easy. But I remember in high school I took a lot of math and stuff, and it seemed like the questions that they were asked about were questions that I was familiar with. As a black outfit, the whole outfit was segregated. We were all segregated during the time. And we were at a location on the base, but we were quite a ways from the headquarters, down in a swampy area. That's where we were stationed. But anyway, we found out what days that they gave the exams for the, you know, they didn't give a special exam for the cadet Tuskegee Airmen. They just gave regular flying exams that for all the flyers that to get into to the flying service. And we took the exams that they, with about, I think it was about 80 of us that took the exam, 80, they were all white. And we completed it quicker than the rest of them, and we went out in the hall to wait for the results, both of us, Quinn and myself. And then finally they all finished, they gave them all the time, and they came and they called us in. And I remember when they called us in, the first thing the instructor asked who was Hayes and Quinn. And, you know, they didn't know, they couldn't, you know, they had our names recorded, but they didn't know which is which. So we said we were the two black ones. So the only thing he said to us, he said, you two scored the highest score that ever scored down here at the field. I scored 94 and Quinn scored 97. So we were in. Then I tried hard. I wanted to fly commercially too, because I got a commercial license, which we got, you know, because I flew bombers, and I thought that would help me. But I couldn't get a job at flying, and that really made me feel very bad, because I just thought, I said, well, if I can fly that well, why can't I fly commercially? Right after I got married, you know, I built a house, because we rented for a year or so, but I built this house, the same house I'm in now. And my wife, I gave her my pea coat, my coat, you know, and had it made over for her. And then I never even thought much about it, you know, after I came out. But I remember when I was going to see her, I was riding on a subway, and while I'm riding on the subway, I guess they were college girls, but they were white girls. And they came and they sat alongside me, and they sang the Air Force song. I felt pretty good about that, because they recognized me, you know. And I always thought that was pretty neat.
So many stories, and just so important to remember what this weekend is about. Thank you, Nick, so much for sending that over, and for kind of taking us out on this beautiful, beautiful Friday. What a gorgeous day it was today. Still cold, but important to remember. There it was, number 5 right there. Still cold out here, but it's still, I don't know, it's an interesting time for sure. But you know, it's funny, I lived in overseas for almost 4 years. I went to university over there. And when I left, when I was 17 or 18 and I went there, I wanted to get out of this country. It was like early 90s. And I was a super opinionated college student and, you know, didn't have a really great relationship with my country. And over the course of that 3.5 years, I got such a deep appreciation for what we have here. And even in these incredibly stressful times and tested times, to see what the people are doing and coming together at the food pantries and community. And everyone that I've been talking to has said the same thing. We're now 3 months in, guys. We should really, first of all, tip our hat to those of us in the New York area. We did what we needed to do right now to get through to flattening the curve. We did what we needed to do. And especially out on the East End, I mean, we were in quarantine for 10 weeks Two of my children have not had a play date since then. My 14-year-old is only allowed to see one person, but, you know, we're doing what we have to do to get by, and our community, even though it is more stressed than it's ever been, I feel in some ways has never been stronger. And that's just based on what I'm seeing and feeling. And so, you know, happy Memorial Day to all of you. I know it's going to be a different kind of summer, but we're doing what we can, and we're here together, and we're taking a moment, and I'm going to just play one more song for you, and then I'm going to head out. I don't know what next week. Who had opinions in college, Retrita? I should be reading these. The food pantries are doing an amazing job, but so is everybody. I mean, I'm sorry, but if you're out there, you got to meet Nippleman? Oh, you got to meet Nippleman as a photo. Did you see how I stopped him? Like, you met him for real? Like, you saw him in the street? Okay, yes. Yeah, where are we going to go with music? Hold on. I'm going back to David Byrne. Sorry. I was digging this song today. And teaching and everything has its silver linings. Look, if you've got your health, you've got everything. And if you've got your friends, and I think it's such an incredible time for, I keep saying the bank system, right? What's in the bank? What have you done? How did you live your life prior to this? And so whatever you've done is in the bank right now. So, you know, you don't get to see your friends and you don't get to touch them as much, or you don't get to, but did you? That's the question I think a lot of people, and I did. I loved fiercely while I was able to. And I know all of you were. So have a great weekend. We're going to chat while David Byrne has 4 minutes here. We're not going to go for our usual 2.5 hour jaunt today, people. I did a doubleheader today. I hope you enjoyed my Memorial Day special. And that you maybe are leaving feeling a little different and a little better. That is my hope. I love you guys. Rich, you're welcome. Thank you for checking in. Are you out here? I didn't see that before. You may tell yourself, this is not my beautiful house. Mamba's D'Agostino. Mamba's in the house. Carl's, so glad you're feeling well. Do we have any idea you're going to just leave it up to Mama Bear? You're going to leave it up to Mama Bear to pick up? No, 2 weeks. Okay, cool. We'll see you then. Anda, I'll chat to you this weekend, sweetheart. The Mamba's in Montauk. Mamba's in the house. We started a mask campaign in Montauk this weekend. Such amazing work. Yeah, are we having a little like flurry? Are we having a little woof woof? I don't know. What are we thinking next week, huh? I don't know. I got to think about it. Maybe seafood or vegetarian or something. We've done so much meat. It has to be a food theme. God, is he so talented or what? Just love him. I can't think right now, but I'm going to pick a theme. And no, Kerry, I'm not picking disco again. No, I love meat too, but I'm just saying, Jack, you're a newbie, okay? You're new to this. Seafood and soul, Friday fish fry. Ooh, I like that. Paella. Raw food, no, we can't do COVID raw food. Carol, I like it, but... Oh, lobster roll? Disco veggie. Oh. Disco veggie is good. Uh-oh, I saw two paellas now. Rock lobster. Rock lobster? Grill and chill. Rock lobster. I'm thinking rock lobster. Yes.
Frisco Veggie is so funny. Uh-oh, we've got two for Rock Lobster. Jack, just so you know, we pick the theme at the end of the show. Fish is a no-brainer. I think paella is more when the summer goes in. I like ribs. I like ribs. Let's wait until it gets a little bit warmer. Disco Veggie is really, really funny. Rock Lobster, guys. You can't get better than Rock Lobster. Rock and Roll Lobster. I know, Julie, I'm with you. Disco Veggie. I don't know. That's a hard call, I have to say. Disco Veggie is so funny, but Rock Lobster, do not like the Disco Veggie. You're trying to influence them? Oh, Casey, thank you for tuning in. I feel better, too. I feel better. I was so sad today. Disco Veggie Stew, do Rock Lobster. Oh, this is our Brews and Blues. You know what, the Souls? We did Blues, Brews, and Barbecues last week. Hold on. I have to say, I'm leaning towards Rock Lobster. But my heart's also went for Disco Veggie. What is Disco Veggie? Disco Veggie, in my mind, is a veggie. We're dealing with veggie. We'd be dealing with veggies and maybe made on a disc. And then also some disco in there. The problem is that I can't do music themes as much because I would like the music to be kind of whatever I can kind of throw out there. I still want to obviously play my own music and stuff like that. And so what happens is that when I have a music theme, I really do run into problems putting disco and really established music on the thing. Like I can have it in the background, but if I put up videos, I can't do it. The Stones and Stone Crabs. You're going to a whole new level now. That, the Rolling Stone Crabs.
Oh, it's back to that. Sorry, it just went right into that. There's nothing I can do now. This is like our late night gang. Somebody said to me, I don't know if you're Snow White, Robin Hood, or the leader of the mafia. I said, what the hell is that? Oh my God. All right, disco veggie lobster with a side of stone grape. No, it's got to be tight and clean. I got to do the graphics in my sleep because I have no time. Fish and funk is very good. Although I have to say the funk and the fish, funk is not a word I like to use with my fish. Funky fish. We already went here. Hold on. Oh, I have Halloween. What's this? Hold on. Oh. Such a good song. The Specials. This is my song for Memorial Day weekend. Hold on. Hold on, my speaker's going out. Hold on.
This time is coming like a ghost gun.
Hold on. Hold on.
All the clubs are being closed.
Oh my God. I gotta rewind this now. Hold on. This is one of my favorite songs. It reminds me of being 17. No tipping. It's all right. All right, I got it. All right, don't get the crab on the crab. Rock lobster's too good. Does anybody remember the Scatolite, the Scofflaws in Sag Harbor? Tracy Winningham Combs now, but Tracy Winningham turned me onto this. Oh, so pretty. I'm just enjoying you guys taking over the show. I'm just reading the comments now. Do we want a little more fireworks? I have another thing of fireworks I can play for us. As we talk. Yeah, no, I was talking about the Scofflaws before that. That's why, you know, maybe if I brought these, oh, look at this. Oh, look at this, I can do something funny. Hold on. The funky smelling. Look at this. Oh my God, you're writing so fast. Okay, you have no place to go. You're delayed, me too, okay. All right, this is from... This time, Okay, so let me ask you this. Where was your go-to spot if you lived out here when you were younger? Do you remember Oceans? Anybody remember Oceans? Scott and Scallops. I think I've chosen it. I've chosen it, and it's gonna be Rock Lobster. I'm choosing Rock Lobster, and that's it. I love trombone. I have a little bit of a weak spot for trombone. I broke up with a boyfriend, and I'm one of these people that I'm incredibly loyal. So when I would go out with somebody, if I really wanted to seal the deal with it being over, I would go make out with someone, because then I'm so loyal that if I made out with someone, then it would be done. So I broke up with this guy, and I went out. I was working at the clam bar, and they all knew me as this like really, really rigid manager. I used to manage the clam bar. I mean, I lived there. I would work literally 14 hours a day. And so I went and I got so drunk, and I made out with a guy that worked at Fiero's Pizza. And for the rest of the summer, on the dance floor, I made out with him. The rest of the summer, my entire staff called me Pepperoni. Pepperoni. It was like respect was gone. Okay. All right, remember the place in Southampton at the light? Le Mans? Danceteria? No. Le Mans. What about the Jag? Anybody remember the Jag? The Chiquit Basement Bar. Oh, that's good. That's good. Le Mans was fun. I met my husband at Diamond Lil's. How about that? Diamond Lil's? Remember Diamond Lil's? I remember Diamond Lil's because I was sitting at a bar once and the girl came up to me and she said, "Hi, Nancy, do you remember me?" And I went, "No." And she goes, "You used to babysit me." And I was like, then I stabbed her in the head and the ambulance came. No, I didn't really. I'm just saying. There's nothing that will make you feel older than sitting at a bar and someone coming up to you and saying, "Oh, hi, you used to babysit me." Okay. Oh my God, my cousin said I gave me a little Monty. I remember Diamond Lil's. The Point Happy Hour. The Point. Totally. All right, I'm on to water. Friday nights are not great for my liver, I have to say. It's my Saturday morning. Okay, I'm done with Ghost Town. How about a little bit of, I don't know if I want that. Sorry. Oh, Easy Skankin' from Iz. Is anybody doing any barbecuing this weekend? Easy skankin'. Let's watch a little bit of fireworks together. All right, we can talk, keep talking. A reminder, Handsome House. Oh my God, the Handsome House. The best. The Handsome House. All right, some fireworks from 2018. We'll be right back. Good night, everybody. Julie, thank you for coming every week, and thanks for tuning in, and thank you for giving me something to do. I really mean that. I really look forward to this, and I look forward to connecting with all of you every week, and you're with me now because I'm thinking of you, and I'm thinking of things that make me smile that might make you smile. So, good night. I'll see you next Friday. 2 weeks from now, I'll be doing a show at the Talk House, which will not be Friday. It'll be Thursday, June 4th. I was going to do it with Cliff, but I got a thing. Sharon, good night. Where are you going? The Souls is ready to, like, rock all night. I have to go. I'll see you next week, though. And I'll try and update my website this week, too, so that we can do it. And Rock Lobster will be the theme. We'll have a lobster roll. I know how to make a mean lobster roll. I worked at the clam bar for years. And I'm going to get some rest. But you know what? I'm going to sleep well tonight. And my energy has changed since the start of the show. So thank you. Because you gave that to me. Good night, Rich Silver. Thank you for tuning in. And I look forward to catching up with you and not just sending you a little bit of a promo thing. But quite honestly, I'm always to the wall getting these things done. Good night, everyone. Have a safe weekend. And for my 2 cents, wear your mask. Let's keep this virus locked down. Love to you all. Happy Memorial Day. And thank you again to all of our military and our essential workers out there right now. Be safe, be kind, and I'll see you next Friday.